Hello and welcome to DIY Liquor Recipes. I'm John, I'm a flavor compounder, and today I have a detailed review of a very nice and creamy flavor. This is Greek yogurt from the Flavor Apprentice. Before I start with the review, I want to say that I already know that this flavor smells bad to a lot of people and they try to avoid using it altogether. Since this is very normal to happen with Greek yogurt, I decided to do something today for the first time. I will go over a mass spectrometry report of this flavor and quickly analyze each ingredient and find what each aroma brings in to the total flavor. So starting, if you put aside the cheese smell, Greek yogurt is a very realistic and helpful flavor for DIY e-liquids. It tastes exactly how I would imagine vaping Greek yogurt would taste. It is slightly creamy, it is a thicker than usual flavor, and it has a small amount of tang mixed together with a taste of aged milk. Unfortunately though, most of these flavors don't translate very well to vapor, so if you tried using Greek yogurt as your main or only cream, you will most likely get a very cheesy vape and not so creamy how you would expect when using a flavor called yogurt. So the best way to use Greek yogurt is to add it to another cream flavor and not the other way around. And since we will see soon that this flavor has more than enough milk flavoring inside, the best way to use it is not together with another cream or sweet cream, but together with something that is naturally creamy without any milk or dairy notes. And of course, that would be a marshmallow flavor. Use them together in a ratio of 2:1, so 2 parts marshmallow for every 1 part of Greek yogurt, and both of these flavors together will create the most realistic yogurt vape possible. Now let's take a look at the analysis of the Greek yogurt flavor. As you can see, it is made out of 8 other aromas blended into propylene glycol. So the test found that there is about 80% of propylene glycol base, followed by an about 10% of vanilla flavor, which is used here to mellow out the milk flavor of the creams. If you want more information about how that works, I have a video called Why Vanilla Fits In So Well In Everything that explains it a little bit further. Next, there is about 1% of butyryl lactate, which creates the milky undertones. Then there is butanoic acid, which creates the tang and sourness. And last, there is a lot of lactic acid, which is the aroma responsible for the cheesy or expired milk smell. Now, a little bit of lactic acid usually helps brighten up creams and make them taste more real, but at 10% used here, I can see why some people can only smell expired cheese and not any of the other aromas included. And then finishing, there are maltol and ethyl lactate, which is a sweetener and a smoothener, and after those, last, there is some ethyl alcohol, which is used as a flavor emulsifier to help blend all these different flavors and aromas together. So now, what we can take out from this analysis? We see that there is more than enough cream flavor coming out from the milk aromas used. So if you were to combine this flavor with another cream, then you will most likely get a very strong cheese taste because you are combining the already high at 10% lactic acid with another cream that most likely also contains some lactic acid too. So in the end, you will have something smelling very sour and appalling. This conclusion is where I based my original recommendation of using marshmallow instead of a cream when mixing them together with the Greek yogurt for the best experience possible. Now, if for some reason you want to try TFA Greek yogurt solo, I would recommend using it from 2 to 4% for a light vape, and from 4 up to 8% for a very cheesy experience. If you have this flavor and you would like to make a quick recipe, here is a nice e-liquid you can make. All flavors used below are from TFA. So, starting with 4% of marshmallow, 2% of Greek yogurt, and 1% of meringue. And now with the fruits, starting with 3% of strawberry ripe, 1% of strawberry, just the strawberry, and 1% of dragon fruit together with 1% of sweetener, all mixed at 60% of vegetable glycerin and 40% of propylene glycol. Let this recipe steep for about 10 days and give it a good shake every now and then to help speed up the blending process. This is a nice, creamy and fruity recipe that vapes very smoothly. If you have peach or mango, you can also use them instead of the strawberries. Now, as a summary, I want to say that Greek yogurt is an all-around good flavor and a very realistic approach to the real yogurt taste. But where this flavor shines is when used as a cream enhancer. You can never go wrong using Greek yogurt that way, just keep the ratios at a minimal when first starting out. If you have been already mixing with Greek yogurt, leave a comment and let us know how you like to use it inside your recipes. As always, thank you for staying until the end on such a long video, and I will see you again next time.